Barbara Kingsolver, in her book Animal, Vegetable, Miracle, introduces ideas ranging from GMO products to local purchases to grass-fed beef and even more. In order to encourage healthier living, she even added recipes to the end of each chapter. To recognize her efforts and investigate her purpose, I decided to go to two close-by grocery stores to see if many of her claims make sense. I also wanted to see how much of the healthy eating and the local eating can actually be possible. Hey, so tonight I'm going to go around some grocery stores and going to actually observe some of the phenomenons that Barbara Kingsolver discusses in her book Animal, Vegetable, and Miracle. And ultimately, I'm going to try out one of the recipes that she suggests in the winter harvest section. We keep this love in a photograph. The moon's really big today. But anyway, we are currently at Sprouts. What I'm trying to make is this thing called braised winter squash. And for that, I need 2 pounds of winter squash, 2 tablespoons of butter, 2 cups apple cider, 1 teaspoon salt, rosemary, and pepper to taste. So one of the main things that Barbara Kingsolver discusses in her book is the use of locality. And here we can attempt to find things that are local as much as possible. And by the way, while doing this, I look like a total crazy person, like with a camera. It's like so embarrassing, but whatever. So here it's supposed to be organic, sun-ripened produce. I guess they are organic if they say they are, but there are really no specific indications as to which farm they come from, or like who made it, who transported it, what company it's from, things like that. So here you can see that it's from Star Ranch Organics apples, and there is the USDA organic indication to it and the certification. So I'm assuming that that's like a good sign that it's organic, but also at the same time, Barbara Kingsolver again raises the issue that because of the lobbyists, the USDA organic standards have been degraded by a lot. Which is kind of sad if you think about it, because if you're looking for like local food, it's kind of hard to do that when there are no clear indications of which one's local and which one's not. So yeah, even the tomatoes have like little organic stickers on it. Look here, I guess you wouldn't want to buy a potato that looks like that, but strictly speaking, they are very like edible. So Kingsolver suggests the method of maybe this, like selling the spotted, like visually unappealing vegetables at a discounted rate. And I think if you sell the visually unappealing ones, then I think that would be very helpful in reducing the amount of waste that come from supermarkets. So she talks about how farmers in the winter and the fall and spring and summer need to have a stable source of food. So they actually can goods, and I didn't know about this, but apparently even canned goods can be organic. So they encourage families to actually can fruits and vegetables that they cultivate on their own, and actually eat that throughout the year. I am not a plant eater in general, so this is low-key my first time seeing like so many vegetables. And they said I need 2 pounds of squash, so I'm gonna get 2 pounds worth of squash and they're $1.69 each. So like Barbara Kingsolver says, fruits are vegetables that are organic are really affordable if you think about it. So one of the ingredients I need for the recipe that I'm going to follow is butter. And although I have butter at home, I wanted to simulate Barbara Kingsolver's recipe as closely as possible. So I'm going to get this butter. The butter is imported from Ireland, but it indicates that the cows that it comes from are grass-fed. So a big issue with food nowadays is the content of high fructose corn syrup. Barbara Kingsolver also digs extensively to perhaps the harms of it, the relation and the correlation it has with diabetes. So now I'm in the cookies and crackers section, and I'm definitely expecting some high fructose corn syrup somewhere, but I really have looked through it, but I haven't been able to find anything. So this is actually certified organic, and if you look over here, there are no signs of high fructose corn syrup. Now we're gonna buy the squash and the butter. So I just got out of Sprouts, and the recipe calls for squash, and I really looked for the squash, and I found them. But the label on the vegetable section, it was kind of like off by one. So instead of getting the squash that I needed, I ended up getting the zucchini. And I feel very kind of a little dumb because I couldn't tell the difference between the squash and the zucchini. And I think that really indicates how much vegetables I really don't eat. But I think I'm still gonna try to use the zucchini. And following the recipe according to that, but at least the butter was a success. Didn't see what's going on, but now I know I'm better sleeping on my own, cause if you like the way. Hey guys, so I'm currently at Kroger. Maybe you should go and love yourself. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. When you told me that you hated it. The vegetables here, as expected, don't have any indications of whether they're GMO or whether they are used with pesticides or whether they are organic, but I must admit they do look fresh. So Kroger has a separate organic milk dairy section. I thought that was like quite interesting. Here in general, you definitely see a difference in price. Alright, so today I'm going to try cooking the braised winter squash that was suggested in the book. Chapter, What Do You Eat in January? I realize that it's February right now, but she doesn't have like a specific recipe for February, so I just decided to use the closest one, which is January. So in order to make this, I need 2 pounds of winter squash, peeled, half and sliced into 1/2-inch rounds. I also need 2 tablespoons of butter, 2 cups of apple cider, 1 tablespoon of salt. And if you think that I'm still holding on to something, you should go and love yourself. Alright, so I'm actually going to try and eat this.
As I was shopping, one of the main concerns was, where are these food coming from? Though labeled organic, there are very limited amount of indications as to where the items come from, like Kingsolver said. As a teenager investigating on the issue, local eating is truly difficult because of proximity and, though argued against, affordability. At the same time, you could buy a bag of chips or a bag of zucchinis, and the bag of zucchinis would still be cheaper. So there are definitely ways to eat healthily if you just put your mind to it, but obviously that is difficult to do when you also consider the calorie intake at the same time. Nonetheless, Kingsolver's book calls for a family-wide and a nationwide revolution of consumer habits. Although I will never be able to live on a farm and produce my own food so extensively, the power of knowledge of food extends far behind knowing its composition, but into taste as well. After all, we truly are what we eat.